those who become are those who never settle. They know that there is always a better and greater version.
Believers, in times of adversity, remember to anchor your faith in God's unwavering love and promises. Trust in His divine plan and find strength in His presence. May this message serve as a source of encouragement and reaffirm your unshakable relationship with Him. Remain blessed as you listen.
Speaking. Let me teach you something. If this is all I teach tonight, it will bless you. Please, if you can get my teachings, Why Revivals Die, it will bless you. Listen to it. I teach here on why revivals die, and there is only one answer: the humanity of men. Listen, John was caught up in the Isle of Patmos. Please pay attention. Listen, when John was caught up in the Isle of Patmos, John had an experience of the throne of God. Is that true? And the Bible says he saw four living creatures. How many of you know that everything in heaven is a reflection of who God is? Everything, from the elders to the throne to everything. There is nothing in heaven that does not reflect God. If it does not reflect God, it cannot be in heaven. That's why when Satan stopped reflecting him, there was no more place. So everything in heaven is a reflection of who God is. Are we together? The four living creatures that are before his throne are not just there for you to know that they are animals. No, the four living creatures are a description of the pathway, the path to spiritual progress of a Christian. Please listen to me. They represent the faces every believer must encounter to rise to the fullness of the stature of Christ. The first dimension in the vision of Ezekiel, and in the vision of Daniel, and in the vision of John in the Isle of Patmos, he sees the face of a lion. Is that true? The face of a lion describes the royalty of God. It describes the dimension of dominion, the manifestation of the Spirit of the Lord. And so God begins to teach you that in your path to spiritual progress, that possibility is there for your taking. That there are dimensions where you should demonstrate the power, the authority that has been vested to you in Christ. Listen, stopping there like many people are doing is what creates error. You must describe the four faces. It's not just one face there. Are we together now? There is a side effect to just becoming a lion. Pride can come in. Then the very next face creates the balance, the face of a calf. The face of a calf talks of the servanthood of Jesus. A description that although you are vested with so much power, the purpose is to serve. So if all you are is a lion and you are not serving, then God tells you, you are not representing the fullness of the stature. You are not reflecting who he is. Are you getting blessed? And then sometimes, especially for we men of God, you can serve to a point that people want to kill you. You carry your savings and pay everybody's school fees. You throw away everything. And then he reminds you the next phase that you are a man, the face of the man. He tells you, you are human. Don't push yourself beyond your limits. Jesus wept. He wept at funerals. He was hungry. So it is spiritual to eat. You don't kill yourself saying you are fasting for 1 million days. No, there must be a time you must eat because you are human. Ignoring your humanity to show you are spiritual is robbing the full dimension of Christ finding expression. Jesus wept. It's okay to cry. There are times, although you are anointed, life will press you and bring tears. It's not unbelief. The face of the man. Are we together now? And then the last dimension, he reminds you that you are still divine. For he that is from above is above all. The face of the flying eagle. All those dimensions are dimensions that describe the pathway of a believer's journey. Please hear me. Except you are not living in this end. Life will demand a manifestation of one or more of these dimensions at every time. And you must have the strength to respond accordingly, so that you do not curse God and you do not jeopardize your Christian experience and you do not mislead others. There are men who have stood as lions and they are embarrassed to be cows. They are embarrassed to be men. So even when somebody dies, they say, I can't cry. No, you can cry. You are a man. There is a provision in God for the humanity of men to find expression. As a pastor, you can be tired. People should not just wake you by 2 o'clock and say, pray, God sent you. You can feel guilty. And then God says, it's okay, you are a man. Please sleep. It's an emergency, they should call the police. Is God helping us? So Job was in such a situation. The humanity of Job was tested. Job sat down and had to use the dust to scratch his body. The richest man in the East. Do you know what it means for a wife to stand close to a husband? You can't talk to him. You can't do anything. You can't sit down with him. Women, think for one moment. The embarrassment from those who say you are the one wanting to kill your husband. Especially because you suggested that he should die. And the woman stood there. But Job said, though he slay me, yet will I praise him. I brought you a message. One of the secrets of the kingdom. Before I teach you in detail the principles of the kingdom, is that the starting point of a man's Christian experience must be an encounter with God that gives him a holistic picture of all the dimensions that are in God. Not an aberrated picture that makes God look unidirectional. All of these are possibilities contained in God. You must know this at the start of your experience. Are we together? Job cried. His wife cried. When his friends came together, the Bible says for 7 days, they saw the man sitting down, they could not speak. Job, us that will come and beg money from you, and you are the one now sitting. They began to think, what could have been the reason for such a man's predicament? And then at the end of it, they said, Job, you sin. That's the only thing we have concluded. And Job said, be cheerful. But there was a little boy among them who could not speak. And when it was time for him to speak in chapter 32, he said, well, I was young and you are old, so I was afraid to speak. But I have learned that it is not everything that is done through age. Wisdom does not necessarily multiply by age. Verse 8 says, but there is a spirit. There is a spirit in man. And the inspiration that comes from that spirit can make men of understanding. Can show them secrets. Job was angry. And then, oh, you will learn a lot in this conference. Listen, Job was angry, pastor, and he summoned God. Can you do it today? A man summoned God and he came. Chapter 38, God comes. Look at what we do in church. We clash cymbal, we play keyboard, we say God is here. We claim we are trying to bring his presence as if he's missing. But a man summons God and God comes to explain himself. What mystery did he know? I'll be teaching you. How can a man bring God to the scene? Brothers and sisters, God came. Job said, God, I need an explanation. And in chapter 38, verse 1, he came. And they began to communicate mysteries. He said, Job, you have been speaking, or paraphrasing, and I've been hearing. Where were you when I founded the earth? It was a discussion of mysteries in the kingdom. Geography tells us the earth is round. That's a lie. Write it in your exams and pass. But that's a lie. Because the Bible tells us that the earth was built upon a cornerstone. There was a foundation laying ceremony. Have you seen the foundation? Where is it? But the Bible says it is there. What do you not know that is responsible for results? Listen, results do not happen. They are activated upon the strength of mysteries. This is what I came to teach you. Dominion is not an impartation. There's no such thing as an impartation of dominion. Dominion is the resultant effect of your comprehending the mysteries of the kingdom. When you comprehend the mysteries of the kingdom, then you can legislate on behalf of heaven. You don't just speak just because you're a Christian. No, sir. you speak upon a mystery. Jesus was the one who began to teach us in Matthew 16 about how he was going to build his ecclesia, the church. This is what Jesus said. He said, who do men say that I am? Is that true? And then he says, oh, you are this, you are that, you are Elias. He said, but you, who do you say that I am? And this is what Peter by the Spirit says. He says, I know who thou art. He says, thou art Christ. Follow me. The Son of the living God. And then he looks at him and says, flesh and blood. That means that revelation is not in the realm of flesh and blood. Flesh and blood has not revealed this to you. Is that true? But my spirit. Right? And this is what he says. He says, and thou art Peter. Listen. And upon this rock, the rock is not Peter. The rock is an understanding. Listen. Upon this understanding, I will build my church. What is the understanding? Hold on. That before you speak, you must have revelation of what you are saying. Upon this understanding, I will build my church to function. Please listen. Upon this understanding, that you don't just speak things. No, you speak things from the standpoint of revelation. It is the revelation that triggers performance, not the speech. So there was one who the Bible called the sons of Sceva. They thought it was just by speaking. And they saw Paul do it. Is that true? And then they brought somebody, a demoniac, and they spoke correctly, but they understood wrongly. So nothing happened. They said, we adjure you by Jesus whom Paul preaches. They did not build on the rock. There was no understanding that sponsored that result. Please listen to me. You will command spiritual power when you understand this. Even your being saved is upon that law. Right? Romans chapter 10. It says, who shall ascend to the heavens and all of that? He said, but the word is nigh thee, even in your heart and in your mouth, the word of faith which we preach. Is that true? That if you do what? You believe in your heart. Is that true? And then you confess with your mouth, you shall be saved. Then he says, first, for with the heart, man believes. Then with the mouth, out of the abundance of that which you have believed, confession is made unto soteria, salvation. Unto healing, unto deliverance, unto anything. Meaning, speaking without having the revelation is a mockery. This is where we mock ourselves in church. I will never be sick, you are sick. I will never be poor, you are poor, because you are not speaking on the rock. It's just a repetition.